Hey, hello friends, this is Sagar Joshi. Today we're going to learn something about SQL related queries. So these are the topics which we'll be covering today. The first is the order by keyword, like operator, between operator, delete, drop and database. So start with the queries. So we are using this m table. So we'll just execute this query. So as you can see, there are three columns. That is MID, MName, and MSalary. And there are five different values. So let's start with the order by keyword. So why we use the order by keyword? So if you want to sort the values, whatever values are over here in, suppose if we take an example, MName, if you want these values to be sorted, so we'll use order by keyword. If you want to sort it in ascending order or descending order. So let's write the query. Firstly, we'll sort it in ascending and then descending. Select star from the table name, just m table, the name of the table. Order by. Will specify the column name, the one which we wanted to be sorted. M name is the column name. ASC, if we want to sort it in ascending order, then we'll use ASC. So we'll just run the query along with the select query. So over here you can see this column name M name has been sorted in ascending order alphabetically, like whichever letter comes first, it will be sorted first, and then the lower letters. So this is for ascending order, and the query remains almost the same for descending order. We'll just change this ASC to DSC. Now let's execute this. So this, the column M name has been sorted in descending order. The letter which comes last will come first, and then the other letters. So this was about the order by keyword. So let's see the like operator. Suppose you want to find a name, but you don't know the exact name. You just know the first letter or the last letter or the in-between letters. So there we can use like keyword. So we'll just write the query. Select star from table name where m name. So we are finding a name. M name like. If you want to find a name whose name starts with letter J, so you only know the first letter. So we'll just write the first letter and then use the wildcard operators. This is a wildcard operator. We'll execute this. So over here, the output will be these two rows, the last two rows, John and Jack. So let's see if we can get this output. And yes, we have got the output as the John and Jack. So suppose you want the output as this row, this particular, the third row, the Michael row. So we'll just, and you know the in-between letters, like you know the third and fourth letter is CH. So we'll just use this operator and you write CH, and again you use this operator. Let's see if we can get the third row. Oh, and yes, we have got the third row. So this is about the like operator. Let's see how we can use between operator. So if you want the salary to be displayed only between 1000 to 5000 and you don't want the rest employee salary details to be displayed, so there we can use between operator. Like we can use select star from the table name m table where m salary between 1000 and 5000. So if you want the salary of only those employees will be displayed whose salary is between 1000 and 5000. So over here we'll check which what all salaries are between 1000 and 5000. So this is a row, John salary is 1000, this will be displayed. Jack salary is 3000, this will be displayed. And Michael salary is 4000, this will be displayed. These two rows won't be displayed as this is out of the range. This is not between 1000 and, you know, 5000. So let's execute this. And yes, we have got the expected output. See how we can use delete. So if you want to delete a particular row, or if you want to delete all the values from a table, we'll use delete. We'll just write the query delete from the table name, which is mTable, where. So if you want to delete the second row, the Jack's row, so we'll write where emp name equals to Jack. We'll just run the query, and when we'll run the query, will this row will be removed from the table. We'll just run the select query, and we are left with only four rows. The second row, the Jack's row, has been deleted. So where we can use drop? If you want to delete the whole table structure, then we can use drop. So we'll just write the query as drop table name. We'll just run this query, and when we try to run this select query, you will get an error saying that invalid object name mTable. So the whole table structure has been deleted. You won't. Let's see how to create a new database. There are two ways where we can create a new database. Firstly, we can write a query like create database name like mTable test. So we'll run this query. Okay, we'll just check out here. This has been created. A new database has been created. Or you just select this database section, right click over here, select new database, enter the database name like testing employee for, you click on OK, and we'll just check it over here if it has been created. Oh yes, testing employee for, this new database has been created. So this is all about these six queries. I hope you have learned something from these six queries. Thanks for watching this video. For .NET related interview questions, tutorials and videos, you can visit our site dotnetinterviews.com. You can also subscribe us on our YouTube channel for more videos. The name of our YouTube channel is .NET Interviews. Thank you.